I am joined by Shari from the Deaf Action Center, as well as Dr. Yvonne Laborde with Ochsner Global Health Education and Public Health, and Dr. Father Sergio Serrano from the Hispanic Apostolate. And I think we'll also be expecting Dr. Chantel Hebert-McGee to join us soon. So we want to give you an update on what's going on with the vaccination efforts. You know, early on, Jefferson Parish with COVID, we took the position that we would do whatever we could. We got involved with testing. We had one of the very first federal pilot testing sites. I believe it's the longest lasting federal pilot testing sites. We still run that at our Ilario Center. Ochsner has been an incredible partner with us doing community testing. And when it got time, when the vaccine started getting emergency use authorization, I certainly wanted us to be in the vaccination game, and we are. Our team was tired, but especially Joe Valiente, who's actually on a call right now regarding vaccinations, he's not here with us. He leads our emergency operations team. I want to give a special shout out to them. Everything I've asked them to do, they have done, and they have done it willingly. And even when I knew we wanted to really get in as much of the vaccination distribution as possible, at that very first vaccination event we had, they were working it, and there was a smile on their face, and I knew that was the right thing for us to be doing, to let them bring it home. They needed that mentally, and they've been really making us proud with that. So many departments have contributed to that effort. Obviously, our emergency operation, recreation fleet, our streets, traffic engineering, sewers, general services, citizens affairs, our public information office with Gretchen Hurt here, as well as Jefferson Parish Sheriff's Office. Many departments are helping us stand up these sites, whether they're community sites or whether they're large vaccination sites like we did the other day at Vaccine Fest, where we did you know, nearly 5,000 vaccines in a 24-hour period. So now that the governor's opened this up, the eligibility criteria is to all adults 16 and above. 16 and 17, remember, have to search out for the Pfizer vaccine. The demand for these large testing sites and demand is starting to diminish, and we will see that start to diminish over this week and the next week. So everybody who was really searching to get a vaccine, waiting for their turn, you know, we're at the point where they're able to start, you know, getting vaccines, and we need to start, you know, turning the corner to people who have a little bit harder access. People who want the vaccine just have a little bit more difficult time. And so we're here ready to announce two new programs in Jefferson Parish to do that for people who have had a little bit more difficulty getting the vaccine, who want the vaccine. The first one is a homebound program. These are for individuals who just cannot get out of their home. They're homebound. They might be bedbound. We're in a partnership with Ochsner and Ready Responders that will go directly into their home with a Johnson & Johnson vaccine, and that's what we're going to do. You know, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is the easiest vaccine. It's the one shot, and especially when you're taking resources to get to that person, having to schedule something like this a second time at just the right time is more difficult. So we think it's an appropriate use of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine. Anyone who is homebound or bedbound wants somebody to come to their home and give them a Johnson & Johnson vaccine. The number you call is 504-518-4020. This call center is going to be active Monday through Friday, 9 to 4. The number is 504-518-4020. The second program we're announcing today is a little bit different, but it's, again, trying to reach people who want the vaccine but just need some additional assistance. This is the ambulatory challenged, the mobility impaired, people who can get out of their home, but they need assistance to get out of their home, physical assistance, whether it's through a wheelchair, a walker, or a cane. They need some physical help to go somewhere and get a vaccine. You call the same number, 518-4020, and we're going to use our community buses. We'll pick you up and transport you to one of our partner clinics, and we're partnering with three different clinics to do this initiative. Oak Street Health, they're in Metairie near LaSalle Park on Airline. GenCare has locations in Kenner, Metairie, and Gretna near the Tarrytown area. And our community health, which is also in Gretna. So again, if you are someone who just needs physical help to get a vaccine and you want a vaccine, you call the number 518-4020 and we will pick you up in a bus and help you get on that bus and bring you to a partner clinic. Also want to announce that we're in a partnership that the Louisiana Department of Health is working with the National Guard, is a pilot program in Region 1. There are five zip codes. Jefferson Parish will have two zip codes. We have found that these zip codes, just vaccination is not as heavy in those zip codes. So it's 70062 and 70058. This is a pilot program. Jefferson Parish has two of those zip codes. And the first one in 70062, which is the Kenner area, with this partnership with Louisiana Department of Health and the National Guard, will be at Iglesia Gracia y Restauracion. That's in Kenner, partnership with Louisiana Department of Health, giving vaccines Tuesday, April 6th from 3 to 8. So what you see is we're trying to get more into the community and more to the people who are looking to get this vaccine. Other events coming up soon for people who are interested in getting a vaccine. The Jefferson Parish Health Unit in Marrero is partnering with Louisiana Department of Health. They give out the vaccine every Wednesday from 8:30 to 3 p.m. We are doing an event in conjunction with Passport Health at our Ilaria Center. That's a Moderna vaccine, April 8th from 9 to 3. And you need to go online and or via phone and make that reservation. St. Joseph Baptist Church in Marrero, in partnership with Ochsner, is giving the Pfizer vaccine April 8th from 9 to 1. And the Hispanic Apostolate in Kenner, the partnership with Ochsner is on Wednesday, and we're hoping that's going to be a regular event, so a weekly event. We're still working out the details on that. And the Ilaria Center, we're going to give out, with the partnership with Ochsner, giving out Johnson & Johnson April 12th from 8:30 to 6. So it's confusing with all of the different agencies giving out this vaccine and different reservation systems. So if you go to covid.jeffparish.net, we have a listing of all the events as well as how you register for those events. Okay, so that's just the easy way to go see the upcoming events. You can see what vaccine we're giving and how to register for that event. We continue to do free COVID testing in Jefferson Parish every Monday to Saturday at the Ilario Center in Westwego. So you wanna, we continue to do that, but because of the increase in demand in the vaccine and we were starting to see some of our community testing sites decrease, we kind of flip those to focus on the community vaccine efforts. So we are not standing up as many community health testing sites because we're turning our attention to the vaccine. As you know, the governor announced this latest order in effect until April 28th, where we were all happy to see the capacity restrictions at business establishments were removed for most of them, the restaurants, the bars, the gyms, the retail salons. The bar and alcohol service hour restrictions was removed. There's still a limitation of large gatherings at your reception and your event halls at 50% with a 500 cap. And of course, a statewide mask mandate is still in place. So I want to thank you all for being here. We're happy to be joined with some honored guests. And Dr. Chantel Hebert-McGee is here. She is our Region 1 Medical Director. So I want to invite her up for her comments.
Thank you, Parish President, for having me here today. I am excited to say that we've given over 2 million vaccines in the state of Louisiana, and I think that's impressive. And Region 1 is leading the effort. We've completed over 20% of vaccines in the region. However, now is not the time for us to let up our guard. We must continue to be vigilant and steadfast in our efforts. I think in order to avoid a fourth surge, particularly since we're dealing with the spring, everyone wants to get out, it's spring break, I think it's important that we continue to get vaccinated. We're nowhere near the numbers for herd immunity. And I think it's gonna take a concerted effort. It's gonna take a communal response. And I think it's time for individuals to really, you know, step up. I know some have been reserved and they're, I won't necessarily say complacent, but I think that people have been hesitant. And I think it's time that individuals really rev up their efforts. I know it's gonna take a community response. That's why I'm happy that we have the parish here who's been really supportive. We're gonna have to meet people where they are. And that means a more in-depth grassroots, boots on the ground initiative to really try to meet people where they are and provide them with vaccine. We know that access has been an issue for some, but I think there's been a lot of efforts in order to increase not only the locations, but also really doing a deep dive into the community and letting people know that it's not about only curtailing the virus and mitigating the spread, but we actually care about individual health. And so I am imploring everyone to continue to be smart, continue to social distance, continue to wear their mask in crowded spaces, and continue to just think about their neighbors, their family, and their friends as we try to stymie this pandemic.
Thank you so much. Next, the next speaker is Dr. Evans Laborde with OSHNR. I met Dr. Laborde as we were looking and doing the COVID testing. And I want to thank the partnership with OSHNR. Dr. Laborde also has been on Zoom calls with us, hosting faith-based leadership calls, involved in the J&J trial. So, Dr. Laborde.
Great. Thank you. Good morning. Thank you, Parish President Cynthia Lee Chang, for having me today. And also Dr. Hash for being here today as well. I'm Dr. Evans Laborde with OSHNR Health. As a physician, I've been on the front lines of the COVID-19 response from the very beginning. And I've had the opportunity to work closely with the parish president, whose leadership and courage in leading our efforts has been exemplary. As you all know, over the last year, there have been great losses and sacrifices made. More than 10,000 Louisiana residents have lost their battle against COVID-19, a sobering milestone and a painful reminder that COVID-19 has taken way too much from all of us. And sadly, for our communities of color, we have disproportionately suffered more severe cases of COVID-19 and loss of life. But as Dr. McGee and President Cynthia Lee Chang has mentioned, there is a light in the darkness, and we do have a way to move forward. Now, we not only have but one, we actually have three very effective and safe vaccines to protect us against COVID-19. OSHNR remains committed, and as a community, we're making incredible progress to remove the barriers, and every dose administered, as the parish president mentioned, brings our community one step closer to herd and collective immunity. So, again, to echo the comments made by everyone, this is really not the time to let up. So, this announcement today is really significant because, number one, OSHNR is meeting people, and we are meeting people where they are to get the shots in arms, because we recognize that lack of transportation and language barriers and other challenges can delay or even prevent people who most need the vaccines from getting it, from getting vaccinated. So we're committed to working with Jefferson Parish and our community partners to host community vaccines across Jefferson Parish in churches, in community centers, and all other types of venues. Last week, we were fortunate enough to team up with our friends at the Hispanic Apostolate, Father Sergio, to administer nearly 500 shots in just one day. What an incredible impact for nuestros hermanos y hermanas españoles, who we are focused on ensure that they get adequate coverage as well. And in speaking of what can be accomplished in one day, in partnership with the parish president, OSHNR recently hosted the VaxFest, which to date has been the largest mass vaccination event in Louisiana to date, during which, in partnership with your incredible team and collaboration, we were able to administer nearly over 5,000 community members their first doses of the Moderna vaccine within a 24-hour period right here in Jefferson Parish at the Shrine on Airline Highway. Again, just to reiterate, as a community, I am truly proud the way that the state has stepped up. I'm truly proud of the way in which Jefferson Parish President Cynthia Lee Chain, with her leadership, have stepped up. And we're making incredible progress to remove, with these plans that you've announced today, to remove barriers and to ensure that, again, as I said earlier, every dose administered continues to be one step closer to what we're all aiming for, a return to normalcy and a return to the life that we once had before. But again, we cannot let up. There's still, as the numbers were discussed, we're far from what we need to be at in terms of collective or herd immunity. So this is not the time for us to let our guard down, but it's actually the time to push forward. I know people are tired and there's COVID fatigue, but we all have to come together and move forward. And please, I implore everybody, get vaccinated for yourself, your loved ones, and for your entire community. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Laborde. So if you listen to our experts, Dr. Abraham McGee and Dr. Laborde, you can find the common themes of reaching people where they are, getting out to the community, removing barriers. That's why we invited Father Sergio Serrano. He has been an incredible partner with us from the very beginning when we did a virtual prayer ceremony, from being with us and helping us get the word out. And one of the issues that we're concerned about is a language barrier. So with that, I want to invite Father Sergio Serrano up from the Hispanic Apostolate.
Thank you, President Cynthia Lee Chain. It's an honor to be here, and thank you for all that you have been doing for us in the Hispanic community. Thank you to Ochsner, to the Health Department. I have to say that I feel very proud of being in Jefferson Parish because so far we have been able to open the doors of the Hispanic Apostolate. The Paul community, or the Old Daughters of Charity, began doing vaccinations on our site 2 weeks ago, where we got 260 people vaccinated. Now Ochsner came, we got over 500 people vaccinated. This coming April the 8th, we will have again 250 vaccinations available. And you may think that it's only for Hispanics. It's intended mostly for them, but it's open for anybody who will contact us and make the reservations to get the vaccine. Actually, every Saturday for the last 3 months, and still for this coming month, we are gonna keep doing testing. Everybody saying hello to the vaccination program. I love it. They are all with us. As soon as I say we keep with testing, the train, see? It's a magic word. Every Saturday from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m., CORE is doing testing at the Hispanic Apostolate in 2525 Main Avenue. So I want to invite the Hispanics and everybody to come to your home. Y quiero decirle a todos los hispanos que están bienvenidos a su casa en el Apostolado Hispano. Tenemos vacunas para ustedes este miércoles 8 de abril. Tenemos también el testing o las pruebas del COVID cada sábado desde las 8 de la mañana hasta las 3 de la tarde. And Madam President, I want to offer you also a good number of volunteers who are willing to go to any site and to do translation. It's why we are opening the doors of the Hispanic Apostolate, because most of the Hispanics lack the ability to communicate in English. So we got a big number of workers who are going to be volunteers to go and to do translations and to be able to welcome everybody. So thank you again for your good work. Thank you to the Health Department, to Ochsner, and to all the partners. And súbete la manga, hispano, y vente a vacunar.
Thank you. Thank you, Father Serrano. So as you can see, we just want to remind everyone, in addition to the events that we're supporting, and as I've said, we've supported in Jefferson Parish over 37 events and many more to come, there's 56 vaccination providers just in Jefferson Parish, in addition to your medical community, in addition to the federally qualified healthcare center. So stay tuned to covid.jeffparish.net for all the ones that we're involved in. So with that, I want to thank you for being here. Any questions, Rob?
Do you anticipate doing any more mass vaccination events, or is this a totally...
No, we still have large events. We're still doing large events, but we're just getting ready for the next thing and starting the next thing because, the vaccine is just more widely available. So The vaccine event was great. I mean, I was a little bit concerned the 24-hour event we had. Luckily, it worked out in our favor. The weather, we had to postpone it a week, but that next week was when the governor opened up. And even going into that, all the reservations weren't taking, and then it filled up. So you really have to make it easy for people to get the vaccine. I think we're just getting to that next place where, again, the people who were searching for it, waiting for it, you know, kind of the vaccine hunters in our community have all been satisfied and got their shots. Now it's about the people who are on the fence or the people who just, you know, it's not easy for them. It's that next level that we're trying to do and get ready for. But I think a couple more weeks of large sites you can still expect.
And
yes.
Do you have a goal for how many people you'd like to see vaccinated with these two new programs you announced today?
Well, we started out with, I believe, 500 Johnson & Johnson that we're going to work with. And I think if it's successful, the state will respond by giving us more. So that's what we've always tried to do with this vaccination event. I've always tried to make it easy for the state to partner with us. Again, this is a trial program that we're going to do. It's an important program. And hopefully, you know, if we use those up, we'll be able to get more. But again, it's a great use of the Johnson & Johnson vaccine for the one shot.
And those people
yes.
who were vaccinated during those odd hours at the mass vaccination site, I know a lot of them had questions about when they'll be able to go back during those odd hours. What's the plan for them?
So that we always duplicate and mirror the same event at the same place, if it's 3 weeks or 4 weeks later. So Ochsner's gonna do that. And that event was run through Ochsner, so it's their reservation system, not ours. So the ones that you see at the Ilario Center are our reservation system. That's why it's a little confusing. And Ochsner pushes out that next appointment to them.
Provide them the second.
And the second dose is there, and yes, right?
Yes, and okay. We actually give them the appointment.
Yes, and Ochsner gives you the appointment. So they'll get that through the portal. Yes.
Doctor, which vaccine have more demand between Moderna, Pfizer, and Johnson & Johnson?
In terms of demand, what we've actually been advocating...
I'm sorry.
In terms of demand, what we've been advocating, honestly, is that either one of those three vaccines are the ones that we advocate. So whatever vaccine is readily available, that's the one that we'd strongly advocate that you actually take. You know, at this point in time, we've not really noticed that because, as you said, we actually had the mass vaccination event at Airline, and that was actually the Moderna vaccine, and we were able to reach over 5,000 individuals. And so, and that was, again, that was the Moderna vaccine at that site. And so I can't really say at this point in time that we've seen any significant difference in terms of a demand or a preference for one versus the other. But we've not really done as many J&J vaccination sites is going forward. But to that question, though, I guess the point that I would like to make is the most important thing at this point in time is to really, the best vaccine is the vaccine that you can actually get into your arm. So whether it's J&J, whether it's the Pfizer, whether it's Moderna, whatever vaccine that you can actually get is the best one at this point in time. Would you like to say?
To piggyback on what Dr. Laborde had said, I think that you should take whichever vaccine is most accessible. They're all efficacious, they all work, they all keep you out the hospital, and they keep you safe. From a state level, there has been a difference in the demand. More people are requesting the J&J product. It's simpler to use. It allows for you to be able to do mass vaccination events, as well as do in-depth community on-the-ground programs and not have to worry about continuity of care. So some people, it's disruptive to their livelihood to come out for a vaccine. They work odd hours. They have childcare issues. And so to only have to show up for one event, it's more favorable. So I think logistically, we've seen particularly communities of color, low-income communities that have gravitated towards the J&J vaccine because of simplicity and getting access to it and not having to worry about a second appointment. Also, we've had a lot of travelers, so individuals who work as mariners, long-distance CDL licensed individuals who drive the tractor trailers, they're, you know, concerned about meeting the 3 week or 4 week appointment. So there has been a demand from niche populations, but we do agree that the faster you get vaccinated, the more coverage you have, and the better it protects not only you, but also our community.
Are side effects any different
Reportedly, it shows that J&J has less severe side effects, so there's typically less pain at the site of injection, and people find it to be a little bit more palatable. Now, is that subjective? You know, there may be some placebo effect to that, that people are feeling a certain way because they feel more comfort in only having to take one vaccine. But what we do realize is that some people do have anaphylactic reactions to the Moderna and the Pfizer products, so J&J may be a substitute that may work for them.
Any other questions?
Okay. Rob?
On a slightly related topic, Cynthia, we were told that a lot of businesses are gearing up, especially this weekend. They were super busy. Some restaurants are telling us that they need like 25% of their staff back, and they're not getting them. Do you have any concerns that people who got stimulus checks aren't reporting back to work? Do you think it could stall the recovery, or is it better to kind of ease into this thing as people are more comfortable?
I think it took us, you know, phases to go, you know, stay-at-home order, and it was phased in, and I think it's going to take us steps to get out of it. But I'm very hopeful. I think the mood has changed. I think this past weekend, you know, the weather was beautiful, vaccines were in full force, and it's crawfish season. So I think everybody's mood was just very, very different, and we need it. We have needed this for a long time. We've worked for it. I think it's energized all of us up here, just the vaccines being out, because it's not like we were working throughout the year. It was kind of, you know, dreary. It was horrible work. So this is hopeful. So some of my friends that are in the restaurant business say they're doing very, very well. People want to start gathering, you know, the whole family's vaccinated. They want to get out, sit indoors again. So I think it's a very, very hopeful time. I have not heard that specific complaint yet, but I was hearing that complaint a lot, you know, in prior months, Rob. But I have not heard that yet. All right. Thank you all so much for being here. Thank you very much.